Good morning, students. My name is Professor Vikas Sharma. I am from Mahatma Gandhi Nursing College, and today I am going to teach you about interpersonal relations. So, as we all know about the basic features of interpersonal relationships, it is the most distinctive aspect of human beings that we all are social beings. It is the well-known fact that we all are social beings, so we have to maintain interpersonal relationship with everyone. Interpersonal relationships have been the core of our social system since the dawn of the civilization. It's not the new concept, but it has been running from the starting of the civilization. Nursing is a therapeutic process and demands an association between the nurse and the patient. Since we belong to the nursing profession, and we have to maintain interpersonal relationship between the nurse and the patient. To define this, IPR refers to reciprocal social and emotional interactions between two or more individuals in an environment. So, doesn't matter where we are, in which situation we are, in which organization we are, but we have to have reciprocal social and interactions between the individuals in that particular setting. It is also defined as a close association between individuals who share common interests and goals. It is one of the most common characteristics of IPR that the people who interact with each other, they share some common interests and goals. There are certain purposes of IPR which we have to fulfill to maintain IPR. The first purpose of this is interpersonal relationship for an individual. So, for individual, what are the aims of IPR that we are going to discuss now? So, the first purpose under the individual aspect is personal growth and development. So, if we maintain IPR, if we do the interaction with the people around us, the people are able to grow personally and they are able to develop themselves. It is undoubtedly the source of enjoyment, as when people interact with each other, they enjoy each other's company and they are able to relieve their stress. It definitely provides a sense of security when the person is among the social members and with the people around him, then definitely he feels secure because there are people to help him in any of the situation. Context of understanding, if we maintain interpersonal relationship, we are able to understand each other and we are able to help each other. By maintaining interpersonal relationship, we are able to meet the interpersonal needs. As we know that it is a well-known fact that any individual alone cannot fulfill all his needs or requirements. So we need help of each other and we need to interact with each other to fulfill the needs of everyone. Establishing personal identity. So when we are in a group or we are member of any particular society, that provides us a sense of identity, that we have any personal identity among the member of the society or the people around us. So, interpersonal relationship for nurses. So, what are the purposes for the nurses? First is building a positive, functional, multidisciplinary team. As we all know that in working in the clinical side, we have to have the support of multidisciplinary team. So, to establish and to maintain good relationship with the multidisciplinary team, we have to maintain interpersonal relationship with the other team members of the hospital. Improving intra or inter-team communication. So, as a nurse, when we are the part of any team in the hospital, then we have to maintain or establish communication within the team and in between the teams. Coordination and cooperation. So, it is an integral part of clinical care in the hospital. So, to maintain coordination and cooperation within the team and between the teams, we have to maintain good interpersonal relationship within the team and between the teams. Building mutual understanding and cooperation. So to seek support of everyone in the team, we have to build mutual understanding, and to establish mutual understanding, we have to have good interaction, good communication with the team members, and that is only possible when we maintain interpersonal relationship with the people. And cooperation, undoubtedly, if we want to have cooperation of the people around us, we have to maintain good interpersonal relationship and we have to interact effectively. Understanding self. This is very important concept when we want to be succeed in any of the area, that we need to understand ourselves, what are our strengths and weaknesses. So sometimes what happens, we are not able to identify and we are not able to understand our strengths and weaknesses. So if we are with the people around us and there are team members, they can tell us about our strengths and weaknesses. We can identify them, we can work on them, we can improve them. Improved decision making and problem solving. When we are with the team members in the clinical situation, we are able to make better decisions, because sometimes we are not able to analyze some particular situations effectively. So in those situations, there are team members who help us in understanding the clinical problems, and they help us to improve our decision making. And definitely we are able to improve the problem solving skills if we seek help of each other, if we maintain good interpersonal relationship with the team members. Like if they are our seniors or subordinates or colleagues, they all can help us in improving our problem solving skills. Now the third purpose of interpersonal relationship is interpersonal relationship for patients. So how it is beneficial for the patient? Developing a sense of security and comfort, fostering trust and cooperation, facilitating communication, improving socialization, developing and maintaining positive feelings. Now there are certain types of interpersonal relationship that we need to understand so that we can establish and maintain interpersonal relationship in any of the area, in any of the situations. So these are classified based on relational context of interaction and the types of mutual expectations between communicators. So there are many two bases in the context of interaction, how we interact with the people around us, and the type of mutual expectations between communicators. So if there are more than one individual in any of the situation, what expectation they have among them. Some common types of interpersonal relationship are friendship, family and kinship, professional relationship, love, marriage, platonic relationship, casual relationship, brotherhood and sisterhood, and acquaintances. So we can see that these are some of the very common type of relationships where people have to. Thank you.